Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the 10th video in the ESP32 series using the Espressif IDE, and today we will start a small series covering how to interface different displays with ESP32. We will use the official library components provided by the ESP itself. We will first see how to use these components to start the basic functionality of the display, and later we will implement the LVGL to use the display at its full potential. Today in this tutorial I will focus on how to connect a SPI-based display to ESP32, and how to get it working. I am going to show the method for two very famous displays, ILI9341 and ST7735. Both displays use SPI for communication, hence we do not need to modify a lot in the code. Here is how the 2.8 inches ILI9341 display is connected to the ESP32. The display is powered with 3.3 volts from the ESP32 itself. The CS pin is connected to pin 5, reset is connected to pin 22, DC is connected to pin 21, MOSI is connected to pin 23, clock is connected to pin 18, and MISO is connected to pin 19. The LED backlight is connected to the pin 4, but you can also connect it to 3.3 volts. I have not connected the touch-related pins yet, we will implement the touch in the upcoming video of this series. Alright, let's start the Espressif IDE, and create a new Espressif IDF project. If you search for LCD here, this SPI LCD touch is a fully functioning project for ILI9341. But as I mentioned earlier, we will see how to do it for any display out there, so let's create a blank project, and we will add all the required things ourselves. Alright, the project has been created, and here we have our main file. Now we need step-by-step instructions for adding the display using the inbuilt ESP functions. Here you can find the same, I will leave the link to this page in the description of the video. They have provided the instructions for SPI-based LCDs, I2C-based LCDs, and even the parallel-connected LCDs. Today we will just focus on the SPI-based LCDs. Before we start following these instructions, let's open this Espressif component registry. Here you can search for the display controller, or any other component you want. There are a lot of results for ILI9341, but make sure you open the one with ESP LCD in it. Now download the archive, and extract it. We need to copy this folder in our project. Let's create a new folder in our project, and name it, Components. This is where we will place all the components we are using in this project. Now copy the ESP LCD folder inside the Components folder. Next we need to link this component to our project. To do so, we need to create a YML file inside the main folder. I am just going to copy it from the ESP LCD folder, and paste it in the main folder. Delete everything from it, but leave the dependencies part. Come to the second line, and give one space here. Now we need to add the ESP LCD dependency. Go back to the component page, and copy this part alone. Now paste it just after the space. This part is the version of the component library. Give a colon after the name, and put the version in the quotation. Now we have added the LCD dependency in our project, so let's build it once. Alright, the project builds fine, so let's start inclusions. We will first include the ESP LCD ILI9341 header file. Next include all the header files related to ESP LCD panel. We will remove if some of them are not used in the project, but include all of them for now. Alright, now let's go to the instructions page, and follow the instructions to add the display. First of all, we need to create a SPI bus. Let's copy this entire code from here. We should create a separate function, just to initialize the display. This will make it easier when we will add the LVGL-related functions in our project. There are a lot of errors regarding the pin definition here. Let's define these pins. The first is the SPI clock pin. Let's take a look at the pin diagram again. The clock pin is connected to the pin 18. This should be 18 here. Similarly, define other pins used in the project as well. The clock, MOSI, and MISO pins have been defined, and we are not using the quad SPI, therefore they are set to -1. Max transfer size is basically the maximum number of pixels in one SPI transaction. By default it is set to 80 lines. We just need to define the LCD horizontal resolution. Let's also define the vertical resolution. Next, define the LCD host, basically the SPI we are using. I am using the VSPI, as the pins are connected according to it. I have explained it in the previous SPO video. Alright, the SPI has been configured and initialized now. Next, we need to allocate an LCD I/O device handle from the SPI bus. You can read about the steps in this guide itself. I will just copy this code inside our initialization function. Let me fix these pin names first. Alright, now comes the new definitions. The pixel clock determines how quickly the ESP32 can send data to update the LEDs, thus controlling the refresh rate and animation speed. I am setting it to 20 MHz. The command and parameter bits set the bit width of the command and parameter. ILI9341 uses an 8-bit wide command and parameter, so let's set it to 8. Transaction queue depth determines how many transactions can be queued up in the SPI. The new panel IO SPI function will attach this panel to the SPI bus. Let's define this IO handle as global, it might be used by other functions outside the display initialization. Next, we will install the LCD controller driver. Let me fix this reset pin naming. I am defining this LCD panel handle as global again. Note that the RGB order is set to BGR by default. ILI9341 works with the BGR order, so this is fine. But if you have any issues with colors on your display, you can change the order to RGB. The bits per pixel is set to 16. Most of the commonly used displays work with RGB565, which uses 2 bytes per pixel, so a value of 16 is fine here. Change this according to the display you are using. This example here is created for ST7735, so I am changing it to ILI9341. All the LCD libraries you will download from the component registry will have a similar function, just like here in the ILI9341. Our display driver has been installed, let's see the steps to initialize the display now. As mentioned here in the IO operations, first we need to reset the display, and then initialize it. Let's do the same inside our initialization function. We can use the swap and mirror functions together to rotate the display. We will see this later. Next, we will use the display on off function to turn the display on or off. Setting the parameter to true will turn the display on. Finally, we can use the draw bitmap function to draw the bitmap on the display. But the backlight has not been enabled yet. If you have connected the backlight pin to 3.3 volts, you can skip this part. I have defined a pin for the backlight, so I will first set the pin direction to output, and then set the pin to high, so to turn the backlight on. Alright, now inside the main function we will first call the display initialization function. Now we need to print something on the display. This method of interfacing the display is exclusively used for adding some other graphic library, like LVGL. Therefore, we do not have any function for printing strings or drawing shapes, even for drawing a single pixel. Instead, there is only one function to draw the bitmap. Therefore, I have this small bitmap image for testing. I have also converted it to C-Array format. You can do that using some image converter, like the one offered by the LVGL. Here, select the image, choose the format, and click Convert. The LVGL will obviously convert it in the LVGL format types. Therefore, I have replaced them with the general unsigned integer type. I have also included the standard integer type header file. We will copy it inside the main folder. Do not open this file, as ESP IDE will start naming each element of the array, and the IDE will be stuck for a very long time. Inside the main file, include the hello.c file. Now inside the main function, after initializing the display, call the function to draw the bitmap. I am starting the drawing from 00, the image width is 100 pixels, and the height is 50 pixels. The array name is hello map. That is all, let's build the project, and flash it to the board. You can see the display is working fine. We have the bitmap on the display, but it is mirrored. This is not a problem, because when we use the LVGL with this library, the LVGL itself will take care of rotation and mirroring. But just to demonstrate the rotation, I am calling the swap function before drawing the bitmap. Setting the parameter true will swap the X and Y axes. Let's build and flash the project again. Now you can see the bitmap has been rotated, and we can see the correct orientation of the bitmap. So the library works fine with the ILI9341. Let me quickly show another display I have with me, ST7735. The pinout of this board is the same as the ILI9341, only the MISO pin is missing. Therefore, I can simply connect the display in the same manner as ILI9341. Let's make the changes in the code now. First of all, redefine the LCD resolution. The ST7735 works with RGB scheme, so configure it here. Now we will add the library in the same manner as we did for the ILI9341. First, download the library from the component registry. Then copy the folder inside the components folder. You can see the ST7735 source file has all the same functions as we had in the ILI9341. Now include the ST7735 header file. Then add the dependency in the component.yml file. Now let's build the project once. Finally, we will install the ST7735 controller driver. The rest of the code will remain the same as we used in case of ILI9341. Let's build and flash the project to the board. You can see the display is working fine, but the bitmap is mirrored again. Let's call the mirror function to mirror the bitmap around the y-axis. Build and flash the project to the board again. You can see the bitmap is oriented correctly now. Basically, we can use a combination of swap and mirror functions to rotate the display. When we implement the LVGL, it will be handled by LVGL itself. So we were able to interface the SPI-based displays using the official LCD driver from especially. It will help us implement the LVGL easily, which we will cover in the next video. This is it for the video. You can download the project from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.